I'm gonna show you how to increase your speed with this insanely powerful prompt builder for Midjourney. Hi guys, my name is RJ Martinez. I'm gonna show you this tool that's gonna help you with your productivity and come up with different prompts, because you know how important it is to plug in really good prompts to AI to help produce what you wanted to do. So stick around to the end of this video. Let's get into the content. Now I'm gonna show you guys two different tools for creating a Midjourney prompt build, okay? And these are basically prompts that you're going to be putting into Midjourney, okay? And it's going to create images for you. And this is very important when it comes to understanding, you know, doing your research. And I'll show you another way too, how to do research on Discord by looking at, you know, different prompts and what people use in there, so you can get an idea, okay? Inside of ChatGTP, okay? And then also there's this one tool over here called IMI prompt, okay, Midjourney prompt builder. This is also an awesome tool to use. I'm gonna show you how you use that. The first one we're gonna use is, this is a Chrome extension that I'm using. So if you guys are not seeing this on your ChatGTP, you know, screen, okay, this is called AIPRM ChatGTP prompts. And these are basically prompts, they're like templates. Okay, inside of here, it's a free Chrome extension. I'm gonna talk a little bit more about this later on in a different video. So I may link it up here. So check that out up above. This is an awesome, crazy Chrome extension, but it's linked to a community that helps and shares different templates with people in the community to help them with their business, which is crazy, right? So as you can see, human written, 100% unique SEO optimized article. Right, so this is a template. This was created 3 days ago, and look at 800K in views, almost 20,000 likes. So, like, this is crazy right here, because if you think about that, like, this is gonna, you click on this, and it's like, enter your keyword or your title, and then it'll create a whole like article for you, a blog article, whatever it is. And then this is one of the popular ones too as well, outranked article. Okay, that's really cool. But there's a little search bar up here that you can use. You can see I've been using it. So like if I put in like YouTube, it's going to show all the templates for YouTube. There's over 68 prompts here. But so for example, let's use Midjourney. Okay, and we're gonna hit Midjourney, and the first one that pops up, this one has over 300k in views of 3,000 likes, and there's a few of them here. There's 28 different prompts, so you can choose for which one you like. It's all a test at the end of the day, see which one benefit, like which one fits you personally. But this is just amazing, right? This is the craziest thing when it comes to any of this stuff, and I just appreciate this so much, because, like, you know, 2 years ago or a year ago, this wasn't even like well, it was, you know, being pushed out, but like I didn't even think about this, right, when it comes to any of this stuff. But just using these type of tools to help you with your productivity throughout the day and help you with your business, which is really crazy. So this guy right here, 1 week ago, this guy Kenny came over here and created this prompt. Okay, I want to show you an example. So for example, let's type in panda, let's type in elephant, right? It's elephant. So it says put in a keyword. You see down here on the bottom, it says put in a keyword. I just right there just typed in elephant. Okay, elephant. Okay, you could put any keyword in, monkey, any type of animal, or anything that you know, you want to create an image, an AI image for it, okay? I create a lot of content around print on demand. So keep this in mind when you're doing these outputs. These are different prompts. These are different keywords that this tool is going to spit out for you, so it can help you. You know what I mean? You can take bits and pieces that may apply to, like, say, if you're creating like a t-shirt design, or you're creating some type of canvas art, okay, or you're doing some type of image, okay, so what type of image for a design, whatever it is, right? So I'm going to hit this little button right here, going to hit enter, whatever it is, and it's going to ChatGTP is going to put out some information for it. Okay, give us one prompt. We're working on the second prompt, and it's working on the third prompt. I think we were like, what, fourth prompt? Wait, now, keep in mind, okay, we're done. Okay, but it, like, literally, like, even to research something like this, right, it would probably take about 30 to 40 minutes to research. Look how well, you know, put these prompts are put together, okay, to even think about something like this. But it gave us four. So let's say like this one took 15 minutes, right? What are we at right there? An hour to do research on this, and it just did it within 10 seconds or less, right? So we're going to take these prompts, okay? And we're going to come over here to, this is what you would do, okay? If you're unaware what Midjourney is, it's an image creator, okay, which is really, really cool. And it helps you with images. Hit that little dash, imagine, and then I'm going to hit Control V, just copying what it spit out to us, right? And you won't copy this part right here, because basically it's saying this is the prompt, and it does that for you over here in Midjourney. It's, which is connected to Discord. It's a server. Okay, so I'm gonna go ahead and hit enter, and basically give it a few minutes, and it's gonna go ahead and generate what that, you know, prompt gave us right here. And then I'll go ahead and grab this one too. so we can see a few examples, which is really awesome. Okay, and boom, enter. Okay, we'll let that generate, let that populate in here, because it's going to populate in there. It's going to take a little bit for the AI image creator to create that inside of Midjourney, right? And then we're going to come over here to this other prompt builder, right? And which is really cool. So we're inside here, going to go ahead and hit whatever. If you're on iOS or Android, you can use either one of those, or you can just hit the web. Well, I'm on the web right now, right? And then you're going to basically start building out like your own prompt. Okay, images within here. Okay, and you can save them. Like, say if you wanted to come over here, maybe just you like the one that ChatGTP put out for us, right? And we copy that. We can just put it in here. But we're just gonna leave this blank. We're gonna say, you know, cute panda. Okay, go with an example like that. It's gonna populate it over here. You see it on the left hand side. But we're gonna come over here to filters, right? Okay, we're gonna come over here to filters, and it's so when it's clicked the on default by layouts. But if we come down here, like we can see what we want to use this for. Okay, you can see like what. Maybe a coloring book page, right? Which is interesting. I need to create some more content on that because I have a ton of ideas that are really awesome. Okay, maybe we want to create a coloring book page based off of that, right? And you know, there's like, maybe we want to just do that coloring book page or a character. Okay, let's say a character. Okay, when I hit character design, you see that it added it to the end over here. Okay, so now let's say I go to textures. Okay, let's say we want to add something inside of here. But for this example, we'll keep it pretty simple, right? You can mess with any of this stuff. You can go, there's a ton of different textures here. Now colors. Okay, there's like what colors that you want to use. Black, white, blue, violet. You can see like it goes on and on and on and on. Okay, artist, right? You can see inside here, they have like a different, like, you know, different styles for different artists, right? You can pick any, you can mess with any of this stuff inside of here, whatever your personal preference is and however you want to do it, right? There's a ton of different artists in there. And then like camera. Okay, and I'm pretty sure a lot of people didn't know about, you know, the different types of, you know, the out focus, okay, long exposure. There's a ton of stuff that can be done inside of here. Era, right? 1700s, 1800s, 80s, 70s, pretty cool, right? And then themes, there's a ton of different themes, okay? Goes on and on and on. Styles, I'm just gonna share with the whatever that comes up next right here. You know, styles, different styles, right? 3D, which is really cool. Let's say character design, let's do 3D, let's throw 3D in there. Techniques, okay, 8-bit, alcohol, ink, black light, painting. There's a few different things that can be, and some of these right here too, be good for like different t-shirt design. And then the lighting, right? Movies and games, Animal Crossing, Breaking Bad, Black Mirror, agriculture. You just think about it as if it would apply to your design, right? Would that apply to your design? So let's say fashion, right? Let's say I want to a baddie outfit. Let's do that. Okay, emoji characters, you can aliens, you know, it's giving you like, you can even start like vice versa with the character and do cowboy, right? You know, devil, like, you know, you see what I'm saying? You can just, there's different stuff that can be done inside of here. Mad scientist, crazy, right? Background, okay, it's up to you what you want to do here. You can choose a different background if you want. I'm just going to keep it very simple, very straightforward. Okay, and then I can just copy that, right? And I can even just put it, you know, I can start adding, you know, building out different prompts and just keep adding, you know, if I wanted to keep building stuff out, boom, 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 boom. You get the point, right? So I'm going to take that prompt that we had. I'm going to go back, delete. Oh, I think I had it saved right there. So we have the cute panda. I'm going to go ahead and just copy that. And then we're going to take it. I'm going to take it over here to Midjourney. And then I'm going to go ahead and add that prompt in there. Take off. And hit it. Now it's creating the images. Let me scroll down. Let me see if I can find the images that we created. All right. So I'm logged into the back end of my Midjourney account. So if you're unaware, like I said, it goes from the Discord server, then it uploads to your account, but you can see, okay, look, check out this image that it created. So that first image that we created, it's this prompt right here. If I go back over here and click on it, it will tell you the information of the prompt. You can see it matches this right here. A magnificent elephant with long, okay, ivory, with long ivory tusks standing in golden, ivory tusks standing in a golden savanna under a clear blue sky, Toronto. Okay, you can see what it created, and it's freaking crazy. Okay, these are some freaking, this one right here, and this, they're all pretty cool in their own way, but this one's catching my eye a lot because it's like more detailed into the skies. You got the birds flying, and then it has more detail to the elephants, but each image right here, you can create a different variation from each one. If you wanted to, then upscale it inside of Midjourney, right? And that right there, if you wanted to do that, you can literally upscale each image to where it's more detailed, or you create a different variation of each image. Let's say like you didn't like that one right there. You can come in there and create a different image with inside of Midjourney, which is freaking crazy because it's like, wow, amazing, right? Amazing, right? What it can be done and what can be done with these type of tools, these AI image creators, right? Now, okay, this right here, this one right here is the cute panda character design 3D baddie outfit. Okay, this is the one that was created over here in the IMI prompt, Midjourney prompt builder. Okay, and you can see it's pretty cool, right? Really awesome character. That's dope. I like it a lot. And I think it's just, you kind of get the concept. You get the idea. Any one of these would be really awesome for whatever you're doing, any type of character design that you're doing, or 3D baddie outfit. And you can see what I use of the keywords, but this is what it created for us, right? Which is really awesome. And if you don't like any of this too, like, you can go back and you would have to edit the prompt, okay? If you don't like what it spit out, you have to edit the prompt and see what you can do personally, as far as, you know, when you're creating these type of prompts. It's like, you have to edit, you have to test, right? Maybe there's something in there that I put in there that maybe you didn't like, or maybe I did something wrong and that I didn't like, and then I just go in there and redo it again inside of the Discord server, and then it'll put out, you know, in Midjourney, and it will put out a different image like this, right? All right. And this is the second prompt that you can see right here that ChatGTP gave us with the AIPRM for ChatGTP. This is the template that it spit out, the second one, and there's two more. But if we go back over here, an elephant, an old and wise elephant with wrinkled scars and its thick gray skin. This is like, that's clean. Look at that. That's like next level stuff, dude. It's amazing. Pretty cool, right? And remember, like I said, if there's certain things that you didn't like, you can come over here, just real simple, come over here into, you know, this is the thing too. This kind of gets a little clogged up over here, but you would have to scroll down Midjourney, right? To find, there it is right there. And this is what I mean. So like this image, let's say you like, they're all pretty, they're very hard to pick, right? Let's use the first one example. I can upscale it, and then I want the Midjourney to create, you know, a variation of that first image, right? And then I'll create four more variations of that one image. Do it. There. And then it's starting to work. Give it a little bit. It'll start to work on those images. You can see it's working right here. It's giving me four different variations. And then it's going to upscale it to obviously a higher, you know, pixel, like a deep, more detailed image on that first one too as well. Okay. So it's going, you can see it's at 55% and going. You can see right here that it's upscaling another image. And remember, if you guys can't find it inside of Discord, you can go over into the actual Midjourney website to find it for yourself. So let me go, you can save the image, save it real fast, and go ahead and open. So you can see, as you see, you know, it basically made four, you know, versions of that one image that we created, right? You can see like the leaves are different, some of them, right? What else? The leg, you can see like the leg is different, ankles are different. Cool. You know, there's little details to that, right? Which is amazing. I think the tusks are all a little different. Yep, that's cool. See, like, let's see how crazy that is. Now let's go back to, all right, now here is that upscale image. This takes a little bit more time because I feel like it's doing more of like the detail work and making it more prettier, right? Yeah, so like you can do a lot right here with this. You can, like, you know, make it different variations, light upscale redo, beta upscale redo, you know, and then you obviously can go to like the web. If you click on that, it'll bring it over here to your app, and it'll show you width inside here, and you can save it, and it'll show you your prompt that you use, the size, right? And which is really, really awesome. But look at that. It's clean, nice, you know, awesome design. You can do a lot from here. Whatever you want to do with it, there's a ton that can be done. One more thing I wanted to touch on too as well is, if you come into Midjourney and you look at the different, you know, the different sections for, you know, the image generators that they have in here. So general one, general two, general three, you're going to go on, you're going to, you know, there's different, you can see there's different images being created inside of here, but these are prompts too. Okay. People are posting different prompts, and so you can get an idea of what they're creating, so you can apply it to, you know, your create, like the work that you want to create, right? So there's different prompts in here. See dog, beach, unreal, 5, realistic, brown, white, cartoon, Disney style. And you can see how they put a certain prompt together based off of, you know, the keywords that they're using here. So by you looking at that and researching and kind of get an idea of how they're using it, and if you can apply it to yourself to create an awesome image, that's one way to do it too. And it's a very simple way to do, and you get an understanding of, you know, how they're doing it, and it gives you an idea, right? So like, for example, this solar system right here, you can see what they did here and the different prompts that they use with inside of here. Okay. And then how they're talking to the AI and how they're using it. Right. There's several different ways to research this and look at how people are using different prompts.
And you can see how powerful this is. Right. And this is going to help you with your business. Okay. Help you come up with more ideas and be creative. Okay. And that's the goal. Okay. Be more productive, grow your business, help you earn more money with whatever you're doing with AI. Okay. And if you want to learn more about AI, watch this video right here. Peace out. Make sure you guys give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel if you haven't subscribed.